We continue our look back at some of the big stories of 2007. These are the stories that took place in the second quarter of the year from April through June.
I think the children were ready to get back to the new school. I didn't think they were going to open it this year, but I think the children were ready.
For the first time in 6 months, the school bell rang here in Nickel Mines, Lancaster County. Just a quarter of a mile from the old school, this one is appropriately named the New Hope School.
Give the scholars new hope, I imagine.
I was in tears when I called my husband to tell him, because it's just hard.
Hard to watch a place where you've bowled for three decades burn down, and Sarah Long was one of the first to see it. She was inside ABC East Lanes when the fire started.
I had all my arms here. You might be able to see, you can kind of see the scars, like right there's one. And I had it on my knees, too.
It started with what Nisley thought were ingrown hairs, but then progressed.
They kept swelling, getting bigger, and then, you know, when they started hurting, I realized that they weren't just ingrown hairs.
The infection spread to a handful of other players. School officials learned MRSA can be deadly.
Well, today the university was struck with a tragedy that we consider of monumental proportions.
The deadliest shooting rampage in American history leaves 33 people dead on the campus of Virginia Tech University.
People came in and started punching.
But authorities say it got more violent.
Six Penn State football players are charged in connection with an off-campus fight.
Ray was just a very wonderful, kind, helpful person. He was very intelligent.
Marie Martin, a neighbor to Ray and Barbara Diener, didn't wish to be on camera, but did want us to know about the man police say was murdered outside his West Donegal Township home.
She awoke. She went to her mother's room. She saw her father lying on a bed and her mother sitting on the edge of the bed. Her mother told her to go get help.
We will certainly spare no expense in manpower, resources, whatever it takes to find out who did this to bring them to justice.
Someone knows something about this crime.
Tom and Lisa Haynes and their 16-year-old son, Kevin, were stabbed to death in the middle of the night, May 12th.
It was a scheme. It was a loan scheme that was set up to avoid detection, to avoid all internal reporting and control systems, and really a deceptive type of scheme. It was broad and it was deep.
Sterling CEO Roger Moyer tells News 8 the scheme was uncovered in late April and quickly contained.
It was isolated within one piece of the company.
Personally feel that it's up to the individual to decide whether he wishes to smoke or not.
Joanne O'Leary is not a smoker.
Would be a good one for everybody.
And everybody's got an opinion on Senate Bill 246, which would ban smoking in most public places.
The top story this Friday night, baseball is back in York.
And it's exciting. We can't wait to get in. It seems like it's taking forever to get in.
I just think it's amazing being out here.
And this, I'm excited for it.
Oh, I'm very frustrated.
And those like Jan Yant, who lives in Lancaster County's Welsh Mountains, are not too happy about this year's gypsy moth outbreak.
Boom, came home from vacation and we have no leaves on our trees.